गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम टू आवर सोशल सेशन. टुडे वी शैल लर्न अ न्यू लेसन इन ज्योग्राफी, दैट इज एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज. लेसन नंबर 9, एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज. जस्ट सी पेज नंबर 51 चिल्ड्रेन. ऑन पेज नंबर 51 देयर आर डिफरेंट पिक्चर्स गिवन देयर. यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व द पिक्चर्स एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चंस. ओके, in first picture you can see a girl reading book with the help of a lantern. Then where did this resource come from? Next, in figure 9.2, it shows fuel been filled in a motor car. Okay, so from where was this energy resource brought to the pump? Figure 9.3 shows Malti with a pinwheel. She is playing with a pinwheel and her father winnowing grain. So who is helping both of them? Next, which energy resource is used for lighting a lamp, running a rickshaw and heating oil as shown in figure 9.4? What are the various purposes for which man can use sunlight? For which of the above energy resources do we have to spend money? And the last question, which of these energy resources are available free of cost? So, we are engaged in various activities to fulfill our needs. Okay, so these activities where we are engaged in, we need energy. At home, you must have seen you have different electrical appliances. For grinding, you have mixer, okay? Then for cooking food, you have gas. Yeah, so different electrical appliances you have. Earlier, in the past, human labor and animals were used. In fields, there were animals used for plowing the field, and human labor was used in factories, industries, yeah. And mostly you must have heard your grandmother and all saying that earlier we used to grind with hand, means on the with stone. Okay, nowadays we have mixer grinder, so now this our task has become easier. But in olden days, people used to do all the work with their hand. Yes, so but as the man's need increased, several changes took place. So we use the energy resources and different devices which makes our work easier. Okay, so man mainly obtains this energy from nature. So you must have realized that from where do we get this energy resource? Okay, so now we use petrol. Now in figure 9.2, you have seen that fuel is filled in a motor car. So petroleum, diesel is filled in motor car. Okay, then the girl who is reading book, she is reading it book with the help of a lantern. So there kerosene is used to burn the lantern. Okay, then next picture, a girl is playing with a pinwheel and father winnowing grain. There is wind energy used there. Okay, wind is used, it is a source of energy. In the 9.4 figure, you can see there is a rickshaw, okay, then a lighted lamp for running a rickshaw and heating oil. Or here also, we can see there is natural gas being used. And the last is solar. You must have seen in your village, there is solar energy panel, okay. The water is heated through these panels. So this is due to if we get this energy through sunlight. Okay, so these are the different sources of energy. Now energy resources, it can be classified into many ways. They are as follows: conventional, non-conventional, biotic, abiotic, renewable, non-renewable, and substance-based and process-based. Okay, so now there is a table given there down. Let us study it. The following table shows the characteristics of the energy resources. Now let us learn about the characteristics of energy resources. I told you just now there are different types of energy resource. So they are classified as substance-based energy resources and process-based energy resources. Now let us first see substance-based energy resources. Example: wood, coal, mineral oil, natural gas, waste matter, and atoms. These are all substance-based energy resources. And next is, substances do not last perpetually. Now wood, once you burn it, as a fuel, then once it is burned, you cannot get it back. Okay, it turns into ash. Even coal, yes, so it do not last long. Next is, substances get used up. Once it is burned, it gets used up. You cannot renew it. Okay, reuse is not possible. Again, I say this, that reuse is not possible. Once the wood which is burned, you cannot reuse it. Okay, you have to cut another wood if you want energy. You cannot use the same wood again. So reuse is not possible in substance based energy resource. Next is, availability is limited. Okay, for wood, you have to cut down trees to get wood as a fuel. Then coal, you know how coal is formed. It takes hundreds and thousands of years to get coal. Okay, mineral oil, coal, natural gas, petroleum, many years due to fossils and all. Okay, we get the mineral resources. It takes many years, hundreds and thousands of years. Just now, same year, takes thousands of years to replenish them, okay, to get them, to get it available. Except for atomic energy, all other resources are biotic. Except atomic energy, all resources are biotic. Biotic means it is made with the help of, means it is formed due to plants and animals, okay, biotic component. Then generation of energy leads to pollution. If you burn coal, wood, mineral oil, it pollutes the air. Yeah, it leads to pollution. Except for atomic energy, all other resources are conventional. All these resources are conventional resources. Okay, which you cannot reuse it. And it takes many years for the formation of this conventional energy. Generation of energy is relatively cheap. Yeah, conventional energy is cheap. Like coal, wood, you get it at a cheaper rate. Being inflammable, these resources cause damage to the environment. Yeah, it is inflammable. It can cause flame if you light it. It can damage the environment also. Yeah, you must have seen there are forest fires and all. You must have heard about it, no? When the branches of trees after drying, they get rubbed to each other, and due to frictions, there are forest fire. Okay, so it is inflammable. Now, type of power generation: thermal and atomic. So substance-based energy resources, the two types of power generation which we get is thermal and atomic. Okay, I hope you understood substance-based energy resources, children. Now next is process-based energy resources. Process-based energy resources Examples are the sun, wind, water, tides, and heat from the earth's interior. Natural processes are perpetual. Next, processes are always available. It is now sun. Every day when we wake up early in the morning, there is sunrise. There is sun. It's everlasting. Okay? Sun, wind, water, tides. They are there. Okay? Reuse is possible. Every day you get to see the sun. You get the rays from the sun, heat from the sun. So we can reuse it. Every day we get plenty of sunlight since many years. Availability is unlimited. It's enormous, tremendous. Yeah, you get a huge amount of sunlight. It is unlimited. These are easily available in nature. It is easily available in nature. You don't have to go hunting or digging something to get the process-based energy. Okay, it is available in nature. All processes are natural. They are natural. Generation of energy is pollution-free. Now sunlight, wind, water, tide, they are pollution-free. Not like wood, coal, mineral oil. If we burn them, substance-based energy, it pollutes the air. But here, sunlight, heat of the sun, wind energy, it doesn't pollute the air. It is pollution-free. All these resources are non-conventional. Again, this is non-conventional. Developing the technology for the use of these resources is expensive. Yeah, even though it is non-conventional, we get process-based energy resource in plenty, okay? But still, to use this resource is very expensive. Till now, the technology is not developed as such, yeah? So, to use these resources, it is very expensive. In the long run, it is said that in the long run, these energy resources are environment friendly. Yeah, it is environment friendly because it doesn't pollute the air. It is harmless. Yeah, it is pollution free. And type of power generation, here there is thermal and kinetic energy. Okay, power generation. Now, see page number 53, children. You can see a man cooking food on stove. Here see a firewood. Yeah, wood is used as a fuel, 9.6. Then roasting on a coal burner. Here you know shegri we say, no? Yeah, your coal is used to roast corn, which you like during rainy season. We like to eat the roasted corn, isn't it? Then cooking on kerosene stove. There's a lady who is cooking chapati, yeah, on kerosene stove. Then next picture, removing baked items from an oven. And last, cooking on a gas stove. So these are the different energy resources. So these energy resources, we can undertake the following kinds of power generation. Yeah, so there is hydel power, thermal power, atomic power, geothermal power. These are different energy resources. Okay, power generation. Hydel power, thermal power, atomic power, geothermal power. Okay. Now, in thermal power station, it is necessary to burn the energy resources directly to generate electricity. Yeah, coal and all directly, it is burned to generate electricity. Kinetic energy, it can also be used to generate power or electricity. Okay. Now, figure 9.6 to 9.10. It shows that various energy resources are used for cooking food. So, you have to list them. Yeah. And discuss whether we can use alternate energy resource for cooking food. Okay. Suppose alternate. If we don't, suppose kerosene is over. Then instead of kerosene, if we can use an alternative like wood, coal. Yes, suppose gas, if gas is over, then we can make use of kerosene. We can use tow for cooking. If kerosene is not there, then coal, wood. So alternative use, alternate energy resource for cooking. Yeah, with this we have finished first part of our lesson, energy resource. In the first part we have learned in detail about substance based energy resources and process based energy resources, and we learned about the different energy resources which can be classified in many ways, such as conventional, non-conventional, biotic, abiotic, renewable, non-renewable, substance-based and process-based. Okay, in our second part, we shall learn substance-based energy resources. Which are the substance-based, like wood, coal, mineral oil, natural gas, in detail. Thank you, children.